What took you so long?
I had some traffic on the way over.
Where's my Sprite? I told you fucking retards that I had a coupon.
Oh, you have a coupon?
Yeah. You want to print it out?
Yeah, I'll need to see it.
You're kidding.
No.
For fucking Christ's sake. Man. Here. I ain't getting a fucking tip.
This coupon's for Pepsilano's.
What's the difference?
Well, I don't work for Pepsilano's. I work for Luciano's Pizzeria.
I don't give a fucking shit. I mean, you're late. You don't bring my fucking Sprite. I mean, what the fuck?
That'll be $15, sir.
Fucking asshole. Get the fuck out of here.
You like change, sir?
Fuck no.
What do you want me to do with it?
Shove it up your ass. Yeah?
Forgot to give you your change.
I told you to shove it up your ass, man. Wasn't I clear?
Hey, ma'am, are you all right?
Hey, man, stay out of here.
She looks like she might need help.
Hey, she's my wife. I can do whatever I want.
Hey, ma'am, are you all right?
She's fine, man. She's fine. You gonna stop me?
Hey, you stop that.
Aren't you gonna do something? What are you gonna do?
Stop it. I'll call the cops.
Yeah, go ahead.
Stop that.
Come on, badass. Stop.
I'll call the cops.
So what? Go ahead. Go ahead.
Hey.
Go ahead, pizza boy.
I'm calling the cops.
She ain't gonna do nothing.
Go ahead, call the cops. I'll just tell them I fell down the stairs.
She will. Now get out of here, man.
Get the fuck out of here.
Kenny, are you up? It's 5.
What time is it?
I told you it's 5.
Why'd you let me sleep so long?
Why'd I let you sleep so long? Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious. I have to be at work in a half hour. And traffic will take me 20 minutes at least.
Oh, so I'm the one that kept hitting snooze on the alarm.
Yeah, God forbid you use a little insight on that and wake me up.
Just go get ready, okay? What's been your deal this week?
What are you talking about?
You've been moping around for the past 5 days. You come home late from work, you sleep late, and your attitude's really starting to piss me off. What's your problem?
I don't know. I'm having some sort of spiritual problem, I guess.
What the hell is that supposed to mean?
It's just I don't think I can believe in God anymore. The things I see at night makes me feel like shit.
You don't have to feel like shit.
I don't know.
Hey, know you have no buyers for this pepperoni. So if you don't want to give me the fair deal, you can just throw it in the ocean. What? Don't you hang up on... Yeah, well, I'm glad you see things my way. Yeah. Look, if I wanted somebody that's going to be late and fuck around, I would have hired the cripple kid that stands outside a Subway and begs on the corner. What's your excuse this time?
Girlfriend didn't get me up on time.
Oh, so it's your girlfriend's fault?
No, it's my fault for trusting her with the responsibility. Wait a minute, it's 6:02. That's hardly late.
2 minutes. It's 2 minutes. What's your problem?
Spiritual crisis.
Well, look. Jew, Muslim, Buddhist, Shinto, atheist, and even Scientologist. They can all deliver pies just as well as your Jap Christian ass.
Just give me the damn pizzas.
Oh, hey, that guy you gave us. Turns out he's got a great connection for flour. So the boss told me to give you some points.
The boss? You mean your dad?
Yeah. Hey, look. Maybe this time you can actually make some of this.
Yeah.
I knew you'd come crawling back. What? Yeah, we deliver.
Yo, motherfucker. You coming or what? Bitch, hurry your ass up then. Bitch, heard that.
Make it funky for me. Yeah. You feel me? I see you. Let's go. Make it funky.
Hey, man, what the?
Oh! You ain't got no cheese, motherfucker. Next time you see me, bring cheese.
Bravo! Bravo!
You waiting?
Yeah, give me my pizza.
So why didn't you stop that guy or something, huh?
Why should I have?
I don't know, common decency?
Watch it, man, lest you should lose your tip.
2260. Change?
Yeah, all of it.
All right, look. I don't have 40 cents, I got 50. So you owe me 10.
You don't have a dime and a nickel?
Well, yeah, and the change box in the car.
Go fetch.
You gotta be kidding me.
Now. Your cowardice disgusts me. Common decency. Should have kicked him in the fucking nuts. You would have gotten your ass kicked, but at least it would have been a better show for me. Common decency. Think I give a shit about you?
All right, here's your 40 cents. Enjoy the pizza.
Yeah. Will do. Now get the fuck off my property. What the shit? I don't think so. Pizza boy. Common decency. What the fuck do you think you're talking to? And get your fucking muffler fixed! You're putting out tons of greenhouse gases. You thief! This slip says 1060! You fucking robbed me!
Greenhouse gas that motherfucker. Hey, man. You know where 312 Palmetto is?
Yeah. It's right here beneath my bottom.
You know what they call me?
No.
Well, check out the ticket. The ticket you got on me, man.
Telly Savalas?
Yeah.
All right, that's 1212. You got the cash?
Oh, yeah, I got it right here, brother. Yeah. That's $13.
Yeah, I believe you. Why would you blow your last $13 on a pizza when you can make it stretch for 2 days at a Wendy's or a Carl's Jr.? How long did it take you to earn that 13 bucks?
I don't know. A day or 2 weeks.
Why don't you save up some bucks so you can afford a temporary place? So you can get a job.
It ain't easy.
Yeah, but you could.
Oh. You're one of them fancy pants, blowhard Republicans, ain't you?
Look, man, whatever reason you're out here is fucked up. But why don't you take some steps to further yourself?
Further myself, huh? Well, who the fuck are you to say that to me, huh? You ain't nothing but a pizza delivery boy.
I'm working on it.
He's working on it. Ladies and gentlemen, folks, he's working on it.
Let me tell you, you got a nice big cross there. You a Christian?
Huh? Yeah, but that's neither here nor there.
It is here, and it is there, and that is everywhere. I can't expect a man like you to know nothing about a man like me.
What the hell?
My daddy was a preacher, man, and he used to sit up there on his fucking pulpit, and he used to say that God demands that we all love each other and take care of each other and show kindness to each other. But you know what he did the second he got home? He beat the shit out of me and my mommy and my little baby brother, Gabriel. I can't believe in a God he believes in.
Sounds like he had a piece of shit for a father.
You believe in the same God he does.
Yeah, but just because he was a bastard doesn't mean that...
Jesus freak.
Look,
you
I just...
But a Jesus freak, you know, that ain't nothing but a mindless follower. If you can't see why I am out here, then why don't you go back to your pretty pasture and preach to the pretty peach trees and such? Huh? Do that, you goddamn son of a goddamn...
Oh, Jesus.
Little sheep, you mindless, brainless fucking fool. Come on, follow protocol. Son of a bitch.
What the hell are you doing out there? Some guy just called me and told me you ripped him out for 10 bucks.
Oh, please, that guy's a dick.
Some Christian you are. Hey, how's that moral dilemma coming?
Hey, fuck you, man. At least I try, all right? You're just a douchebag.
Well, I may be, but I own this place. So anybody that's gonna give this place a bad name is gonna be me.
Don't your parents own this place?
It's a family business, asshole. Here. Take these and get the fuck out of here, or I will exercise my authority and fire your ass.
Hey, can you have Marcus take this load? I need to turn in. I just need time to think about things.
Look, I don't like to bring politics and religion into my daily conversations, but it seems to me that this moral dilemma is really affecting your work.
This is the last run I'm doing tonight.
Hey, I really like you, Kenny, but sometimes you just make it so tough. Hey, what are you doing? The cheese gets on the box when you do that.
Hi, Joan. That'll be $15.45.
Change for $20.
Sure.
Thank you.
Are you all right, ma'am?
What are you, a good Samaritan or something?
Maybe.
I don't need your help.
About time. I need my beauty sleep.
Why are you still here?
Do you think I'm gonna trust you with my change?
Here. And if you want the coins, they fell in between the seats. Go fish.
Jesus, Kenny, it's like you've been on your period all night.
You're Catholic, right?
Yeah.
How do you keep up with it?
I don't let it run my life. And look at me. I'm wonderful. See, Kenny, you just need to stop being a pussy and figure out what to do with your life. Once you do that, you're all set.
Jeez, great advice, Chaz. I feel better already.
Yeah, I should sell that shit, huh?
What are you doing here?
I'm just leaving in a couple days. I thought I'd come say goodbye.
It's the middle of the night.
Is Tara home?
Yeah, she's sleeping.
What's the matter? Is there something bothering you?
Jesus, isn't that fucking obvious? I'm so miserable.
The Jesus thing, isn't it?
How do you know that?
Well, I called Chaz to see what time you were getting off, and he mentioned it to me.
Well, Chaz should mind his own damn business.
He just cares, Kenny.
Bullshit, he's a fucking weasel.
You know, you're not a very good Christian. And I bet Tara would agree with me too if she knew the way that I do.
Don't talk about her.
She treats you like shit.
Goodbye, Sandy. I'll talk to you before you leave, okay? And don't even think about calling my place. I have enough problems right now.
Good morning, baby.
What time is it?
4:15. You slept over 12 hours.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
What's the matter?
Nothing. I don't feel too good today.
Shit, Tara. You said you'd quit.
Don't think you're the only one that feels like shit around here.
I don't. But I don't have to get high every chance I get either.
I told you.
I didn't do anything.
What about yesterday in the bathroom?
That was the last time.
Last time, sure.
Where are you going? I can't just quit cold turkey. I already cut off contact with my dealers.
I don't care, Tara.
I can come off of it. Slowly. If I could just have one last bump tonight.
What do you want me to do about it?
Chaz.
What about him?
I know he knows where to get it.
Forget it. He's my boss. I'm not asking him.
But he snorted coke in front of both of us at Charlie's house.
It's out of the question.
That's all I need. Don't you care?
Yeah, I do. Which is why I'm not asking him.
Hey, the prodigal son returns.
Just give me the damn pizzas, all right? I'm not in the mood.
Hey, you solve all your problems there, Kenny?
My problems have just begun. This address again.
What address?
It's out in the middle of nowhere.
You're a grown man, Kenny. What, are you afraid of the dark?
No, it's just... The woman is just,
She's another satisfied customer. Look, Kenny, you've got to step it up here and quit your bitching. You've got 3 more deliveries before her, so you better muster up some courage before that happens. Damn pussy.
It's about fucking time.
Sorry, sir. 1 large pepperoni. That'll be $19.25.
All right, here. You just keep the change. Let me have one of those 20s back. I got some ladies coming over tonight. You know, models. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man. No problem.
Hey, come here. Come here. Let me show you my place.
I probably shouldn't.
Oh, bullshit. Come on. Let me show you. You want a drink? I got Poutine, Everclear, Boob Dusters.
Oh man, I think I'm good.
Jocelyn, get your fucking ass up and do something. Make some money for Christ's sake, all right? Come on, fucking A. Yeah, atta girl.
So what exactly do you do, Mr.
Dallas Roughmaker? You can put money on that. Ever see Junior Boner? Major Fuck Me? Bang Me the Cock of Alfredo Garcia?
No, I guess I miss those.
What about Ass-Gaping Cum Dumpster Sluts 18?
I think I missed that one too.
You gotta get out more, kid.
So you acted in porn back in the day?
Acted? Shit, I ran porn in my day. I did makeup, acting, sedating.
Sedating?
Well, yeah, you can't do it now. But back in my day, if a girl had a change of heart, you'd slip her a Black Susan. Nowadays, girls are banging on the door to do this shit. Must be a change of the times or something like that. I had this Canadian dyke from Sacramento going, "Oh, Dallas, no, I don't wanna." I had to fucking duct tape her ass to a chair before I could even pull her panties off.
Why the hell do you do that?
You fucking kids. Didn't you read my book? All right. The theories are complex, but more or less, you can't live life worrying about other people. That shit leads to moral codes, religion, family. Hell, it all just gets in the way of you living life to the fullest. What the fuck is going on here? Fuck! Get him out of here! What the fuck? What the fucking... What are you kidding? Get his ass out of here. Fucking preschoolers around here. Goddamn fucking kids. Fucking animals. So what's keeping you from quitting your shit job and getting in on the business? I can have you balls deep in Karen Toilet Face in 2 days. You could have your own home in a month. What's keeping you?
I have morals, I guess.
Well, see, that's your problem. You could be getting high all day and fucking hot bitches just like me. In other words, you could be happy. I don't think you're happy right now. Fuck morals, I say. I suppose you're a Jesus freak too, huh?
I go to church.
Yeah. All right, see, let me tell you something. My daddy used to be part of a traveling circus, and every Sunday they'd go to church in between slapping bare-titted monsters and getting high off my grandpa's old cough medicine. Don't be a hypocrite like my old man.
Going to church doesn't make someone a hypocrite. And doing drugs and fucking porn stars all day, knowing that it's wrong and doing nothing about it, is more hypocritical than anything the church does.
Fair enough, kid. So you don't want to get high?
No, I'll pass. Got a lot of driving to do tonight.
Oh yeah? Where to?
Nowhere, Zanker Street, then down Peterson Road.
Oh no shit, Peterson?
Yeah, what of it? That place is scary as hell, man.
Yeah, no shit. I worked with a girl who lives in that shitty little farmhouse down at the end of the road over there. Just, you didn't hear that from me.
Really? Who is she?
Why are you so interested? Well, first you put down my lifestyle, and now you're talking to me like we should be friends? I don't like where this is going. Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, I didn't mean anything by it.
Yeah, the hell you did.
I don't want your money either.
Yeah, just fucking leave it there. Kids and their fucking manners these days. Christ!
Yeah, baby, what is it?
I feel really shitty and...
What's wrong?
I need just one little...
Told you before I left, there's no way.
Just ask Chad. Please? I promise he won't fire you.
That's not the point. I don't want any part of this. Besides, you promised me you'd get off this shit, so this shouldn't even be an issue.
No, I promise you, Kenny, but I'm dying.
Let me think about it.
I feel really shitty.
I heard you. I said, let me think about it. Goodbye, Tara. Damn it. Hi. $15.
Change?
Right.
Thanks.
Hold on a second. I was wondering if you could help me with something. See, I've got some extra cash here, and I got a lot more driving to do tonight. And I just need something to, you know, get me through the night.
You want a cup of coffee or something?
No,
Okay, well, how much do you have?
I just need enough for tonight. I got $100.
Okay, come on in. Just close the door behind you.
I'll be right back. It's just in the back room. Just enough for tonight, right?
That's it. No more. Hey, ma'am. I really gotta get going. Hey, ma'am. I really gotta get going. Is everything okay? Ma'am? Excuse me, ma'am. Hey, ma'am, I gotta go. Ma'am. Ma'am, I really gotta get going.
Where's my change, numbnuts? Hey, Kenny, I'm talking to you. You got shit in your ears? You look like you just fucked your mother. What's wrong?
No, I'm just tired, I guess.
Get some sleep. We got a long day tomorrow.
I didn't even hear you get in.
I didn't want to wake you.
Did you talk to Chaz? Well, it doesn't matter anymore. I decided to quit cold turkey last night.
You feel better now?
Not really. But what other options do I have?
Well, 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 look who showed up early tonight. Must be the fear of God in him. Kid has no personality.
Meat lovers?
Doesn't sound like Dallas. My name's Jocelyn. You can call me Josie if you want. How are you doing this evening?
My night's beyond help.
For $100, I can make it a whole lot better.
Not interested.
Why not? You like men?
I have a girlfriend.
So? We don't have to tell her.
Still not interested.
Fucking liar.
Why are you out here doing this?
Because I love it, baby.
Liar.
You don't know me.
I know you don't like doing this. I know Dallas treats you like shit. I know you want a better life. And I know those long sleeves aren't hiding your beauty marks there.
You're wrong.
Yeah, so why don't you quit? Check yourself into rehab, make something of your life.
Well, why don't you go deliver your fucking pizza and get out of my face? I'm just gonna let you have this for $100? You should be thankful. You're not even cute.
You just had to talk to me, so now we're gonna talk. Why do you sell yourself for junk?
I don't owe you an explanation for my decisions.
Lovely life you've made for yourself. You know, maybe if you took a moment to better yourself, men would actually talk to you first, instead of always having to flag one down.
You wanna preach to me? Try getting yourself down in my position and then sell me on getting out. Self-righteous piece of shit. I broke a fucking nail on your face, asshole. And tell Dallas I quit.
Fuck me. Hey man, is Dallas home?
You again? What's up, my man?
Hey, that'll be $20 even.
Come on in. Take a load off.
I can't. I have to.
Come in.
Don't insult me.
Jocelyn's still out there?
That hooker?
Call girl.
Not like there's a difference anyway.
She bailed.
What happened? You turned her down?
She was dirty, I could tell.
She is dirty, isn't she? I'll just get another one. What was your name again?
Kenny.
That's right. Sit down. You want a girl?
No, it's okay.
So, did you read my book yet?
I haven't had time, sorry.
You wouldn't be able to read and process all that complex theory in one night anyway. That shit takes time to absorb.
Look, man, the pizzas in my car are getting cold and I really gotta go, so...
There's a reason I dragged you in here, Kenny.
Yeah, what?
If I remember correctly, you were leaving here last night to deliver a pizza to someplace very dark and desolate.
What are you talking about?
Kenny. Kenny!
What?
I said, if I remember correctly, you were leaving here last night to deliver a pizza to someplace very dark and desolate.
Yes.
Do you know why I'm bringing this up, Kenny?
No more.
I'm bringing this up because a girl who once worked for me was found dead in that house this morning.
Oh.
Yeah, big fucking O. What I want to ask you is, what do you know?
I don't know anything.
You said you were headed in that direction last night. There's no other house on that block for several miles. That had to be the house, right?
I don't know.
Look, I don't think you killed her, okay? You're too much of a pussy to do something like that. But you are a Jesus freak, so I can't completely put it past you.
What's your interest in it?
I told you. The girl used to work for me. I care about my former employees, that's all. If you know something, I want to help the investigation.
Not a Jesus freak.
I forgot. You're conflicted, aren't you? You do not want to fuck with me, Kenny. I'm high, I'm desperate, and I don't give a shit about the life of some random fucking delivery boy. I've had people die in this house, Kenny. Overdoses and whatnot, I know how to hide a body. Please. Tell me what you saw.
Okay. I delivered the pizza to her house, and she paid me. And then... God.
Great start, Kenny. Great start. Go on. You're doing great.
I saw that she was high. So I thought I'd try to score a hit from her, you know, buy some drugs.
Kenny! You wanted drugs and you didn't come to me first?
Please don't hurt me. I don't know what I'm doing.
Would you like me to put the scissors down? Make you more comfortable. Okay. So, you were buying drugs. What kind? Pot? E? Coke? Heroin? I don't see you with a needle.
Coke. It's for my girl.
Okay, well that doesn't matter. What happened next?
She went to the back room to get the stuff. Only she was taking a long time, so... While I was waiting by the front door, I just, you know, I went to go check on her. When I got back there, she was dead.
She just magically died?
I didn't hear anything, I swear.
Have you gone to the police yet?
No. On my way out, I saw someone.
Who? Who'd you see?
It was dark. He was wearing black, a big guy.
He? It was a guy?
I'm assuming he was so big.
All right. And you don't want to go to the cops because you think they'll bust you for the drugs. Look, I believe you, okay? I don't think you're lying. I was just concerned, okay?
I'm sorry I threatened you.
I have to go.
Now, sit down.
You keep your mouth shut about me. You send any cop my way,
tell them what you're doing here.
Look, there's no need for threats. Please, sit down. The pizzas are cold by now anyway. Her name was Joan Skye. Her father was a local preacher. Her mama passed away about 6 months ago. And last I heard, her brother was starting to become a priest. Anyway, she got all depressed over her mom passing away and she got involved in some really bad shit, hence my association with her. But then she started acting all strange. She lived with me for a little bit before she decided to leave and get a place of her own.
I don't want to hear any more of this. Well,
I thought you would. She was a nice Christian, just like yourself. But the devil got a hold of her.
She was a drug addict and a dealer.
You be careful, Kenny. You be careful out there. You're late.
No, I'm sorry.
You're late by 40 minutes.
Well, I can give you a free 2-liter bottle of Sprite.
I don't want a fucking Sprite. This shit's cold. I'm not paying a dime. Dude, this feels like rubber.
You know what? Just take it. It's on me.
What? What's the catch?
It's nothing. I need to get back to my girlfriend.
Excuse me. Are you Kenneth Kitagawa?
Yes.
I'm Officer Sanders. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
I'm on my route right now.
It's okay. You guys can talk here.
Thank you. Shall we? You look stressed.
Girl problems.
Yes, thank you. Would you mind if I talked with him alone? Great, thank you. You look bothered.
Well, like you said, I've just been having problems with my girlfriend.
I see. You're not gonna ask me why I have some questions for you?
Hmm? Yeah. No, what do you want to talk about?
We found a woman slammed this morning in her home. We checked her phone and found that the last call she had made was to a Luciano pizzeria. We talked to a, Chaz Luciano. He said you were out making a delivery there last night.
Which house was it again? I made a few deliveries last night.
This would be the house on Peterson Road. The new house on the road.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I remember now. Strange place.
Yes, I'd be a little nervous to drive out there myself at night. So you made the delivery?
Yes.
And, everything seemed nothing out of the ordinary? Everything seemed okay?
Yeah, she wasn't the friendliest person, but everything seemed okay.
Do you remember exactly what time that was?
No, I can't say for sure.
Okay, according to this, it looks like Chaz said you'd have been out there around 9:45 p.m.
Well, I guess that's when I was there then. I'm rarely ever late.
And everything went as procedure. You went up and knocked on the door. She opened the door. I gave her the pizza. She gave you the money. And we left. Is this right?
Yeah, that's right. I didn't go inside. Why would I?
I see. Well, that's all the questions I have for you now. Thank you very much for your time. Ah, Miss Robinson, thank you very much for the assurance.
You're very welcome, officer. Please let me know if you have any further questions in the future.
What the hell, Chaz?
What the hell happened
last night? You trying to get me arrested?
What the fuck happened last night?
Why'd you tell that cop where I was?
You're innocent, right? So you shouldn't have to worry.
Yeah, it's just...
Just what?
You know I get nervous, even if I'm innocent.
It's just your Catholic upbringing.
Seriously, why didn't you give me the heads up?
Look, I should have given you the heads up, right? She was still alive when you left the house, right?
Yeah, she was.
This is some serious shit, man.
I know. Here's some change.
All right. Get some rest. Say hi to Tara for me, okay?
All right. Tara, wake up. You awake? You awake, Tara?
What the hell, Kenny? I was sleeping.
I was just making sure you're all right.
Why wouldn't I be?
Did anyone stop by today?
No. Why would anybody stop by?
I was just wondering.
God damn it, Kenny. I'm wide awake now.
I'm sorry, all right? Shit. You're all right? Is everything all right? I thought I heard you drop something.
You know why, Kenny.
Please don't hurt me.
It won't hurt you.
I didn't tell the cops anything, I swear.
I believe you. She was a drug addict, just like Joan. What they all say. People like that are nothing in the eyes of God. Don't worry, Kenny. You're much more.
What are you doing?
You never called me.
I've been busy.
You look like shit. Look, I'm in town for one more day. I leave really soon.
I know.
So, are you gonna come see me? You're not even gonna talk to me?
I've got a lot on my mind right now.
Here. I don't think you have my current address. I'm gonna be in town for one more day. Please stop by. I'd really like to talk to you before I leave, okay? You know where that is? Do you?
Yeah, I know. I know where it is.
Okay. See you soon.
Get in the car.
Kenny, I'm not giving you any more overtime tonight.
Get in the car.
Kenny, I'm gonna close up in 10 minutes.
Tara's dead. They killed her. The woman the cops wanted to talk to me about. I was there when she was killed.
Kenny, I'm not gonna get involved in this.
Did you hear me? I said Tara is dead. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Why would they want to kill Tara?
I'm still trying to put it all together. All I can think of is that I'm the only suspect. And with Tara dead too, it makes me look like the killer.
Well, you're relatively safe then.
How so?
Because if this guy's gonna pin the murder on you, he's gonna want to keep you alive. Unless, of course, he kills you and makes it look like a suicide, which, let's just hope he doesn't think of that.
I'm still gonna go to jail, though. Possibly for murder. Shit. I gotta hide somewhere.
It's not too late to tell them everything.
It is too late. I fucked up.
You should have told the cops when you had the chance. They don't put people away for petty drug deals. You've got a clean record. Worst case scenario, they would have slapped you on the wrist.
I know, Chaz. But it's no use thinking about it at this point. There's only one thing left to do.
What are you looking at me for? I can't get you a passport.
I'm not gonna run.
What then?
I'm gonna find this motherfucker myself.
Kenny, there's still time to turn yourself in. Tell the cops everything.
Give me one reason why I shouldn't find this man and kill him.
Kill him?
Yeah, kill him.
Because it's not right.
It's not right?
And you're not a killer.
You've suddenly grown a conscience, Chaz?
Things got a little more serious.
Get out of my car. I don't want your help.
There's a better way.
Let me in.
Well, who the fuck are you? Oh, you're the pizza guy. I don't remember ordering anything, but come on in.
The girl that was killed the other night, who killed her?
Shit, if I knew that, I'd be talking to the police right now.
Who do you think killed her?
Why the sudden hair up your ass? It's God knows what time in the night. I've got yoga class tomorrow at 8 a.m. I need my shut-eye.
I need to talk to someone about this. You're the only person I could think of. You knew her.
Oh, Jesus. Sit down. Why the morbid fascination all of a sudden? The cops got you scared? Are you a suspect?
I need to find the man that killed her.
Why?
Call it purification.
Of what?
Mind and soul.
Have you tried meditation? It works just as well.
Look, you knew her. You knew her family. I know you know something.
Why should I tell you?
My girlfriend is dead. It was the same guy.
What? When?
Earlier tonight.
We'll call the cops then. Fuck, I'll call them for you. Leave an anonymous tip.
So you call the cops, I get arrested for Tara. They won't believe the truth at this point. I want to kill this bastard.
What do you know about killing? I've been in two fights my entire life, and you're 10 times the pussy I am.
Just tell me what I need to know, all right? Please.
Well, I can't say for sure, but I would start with a brother.
The priest?
In training. He's got a head full of bad wiring. He's been kicked out of the church a few times already, but he always manages to get back in. Hell, he might even be this damn killer himself, for all I know.
He a big guy?
Yeah, big fat ass.
Can you write down the address for me?
Let me see if I still have it.
I normally wouldn't do this, but I'm sorry about your girl.
She was a drug user.
That don't make it any easier.
Yeah, I know.
Mine was too. Before I lost her. I don't know what you're up to, but be careful. And you didn't get this from me. If the cops come around here, I'm gonna deny you were ever in my house. And read my book, too. When you get the time, that is.
Yeah.
Hey, man, where are you?
I'm getting a bite near the gas station by work. What do you want?
Look, I was thinking, you know, Tara's my friend, too.
And I want to catch this guy that did this.
Are you bullshitting me, Chaz?
Would I bullshit you, Kenny?
I don't know. Maybe you're working with the police.
I'm not working with the police, Kenny. Shit.
I'll pick you up in 10 minutes.
10 minutes?
You know where.
All right. So who lives here?
The girl's brother. He's a priest. Or he's going to school for it or something. I think he may be the killer.
How come?
Because he's a fat ass. So I'm told.
Yeah, it makes sense. How long do you expect to be out here anyway?
Until we get a good look at him.
Think they found Tara yet?
Probably not. I don't like the thought of her just lying there.
Yeah, me neither. So how long do you plan on being out here?
Well, we have to see if it's him. If it is, I'm gonna have to get a gun somehow.
Jesus, Kenny. Did you get a good look at him? If you saw him again, will you recognize him?
Yeah.
Fuck, man.
Should have called the fucking police when I had the chance.
Oh, stop being a pussy. That's how you got into the situation in the first place.
Fuck you, Chaz.
Well, I'm going home. He's probably not gonna come out this late anyway.
What?
I said I'm getting out of here.
You said you wanted to help.
If you need me, you can find me. But I'm not gonna sit on a late night stakeout on some fucking hunch that you have.
Fine, whatever. Go home.
Go home, Kenny. Get some rest. You're wasting your time with this guy.
Oh my God, help me, Kenny! Kenny!
Oh God! Oh
Kenny!
Come on, gang, let's go. Sandy, we're going out to get some ice cream. You want some?
I still have to pack.
All right, honey, we'll be back in a little while.
Kenny, is that you? Mom? Dad? Are you still here? Your phone, please tell me that you have your phone.
Shit, I don't.
Where did you park your car?
Right out front. Here, take the keys. Alright? When I say go, run outside and start the car.
What are you gonna do?
You won't kill me.
What? Kenny!
Just trust me, okay?
I'm not gonna make it, I've already tried.
Yeah, you will. Distract him. You'll only have time for one shot. You ready? Go.
Sandy, get back in the car!
Just go!
Mr. Kitagawa, step out of the vehicle and put your hands on your head. Put your hands on your head. Found a woman dead in your apartment this morning. You want to confess about it?
I didn't kill anyone. I really didn't. But I'll tell you what I know.
Well, that's a start. Let's go.
You believe me, don't you?
I don't know. It's hard to believe somebody could be so stupid. But I'm gonna go ahead and follow up on the information you gave me. But meanwhile, I have a nice cozy block of concrete in there with your name on it. Let's go. Congratulations. Thanks to the information you gave us, we made the arrest this morning. We confessed to everything. Only I wish you'd have gotten to me a little bit earlier. We could have saved a couple of lives.
I've suffered enough over that already.
Yeah, I know. You know, we picked up that Dallas Roughmaker. Had quite a rap sheet on him. Are you aware that he was running a white slavery ring out of his home?
What's that?
Never mind.
So am I free to go?
You should be locked up for withholding evidence. But since the information you gave us led directly to the arrest, we have no reason to hold you.
You don't need me to identify him or anything?
No, we have a signed confession. That's all we need.
Hey, it's Kenny.
What do you want?
What did he look like?
Who?
The guy that confessed today, what did he look like?
Tall, fairly thin.
Thin?
Yeah, that's right, thin.
He wasn't thin, I told you. He was a fat guy.
Look, we've got a signed confession.
Then he's lying.
Why would he lie?
I don't know, but you got the wrong guy, I'm sure of it. The blood.
What?
The blood, at Sandy Jackson's house. Did you run a test on it?
The only blood we found was Sandy's.
Well, he must have cleaned it up. But there must be some trace left. Go back, to the house and check the living room.
Look, kid, I don't know what's going on with you, but let it go. And everything checks out. This case is closed. You're a free man. Don't give me a reason to bring you back in.
All right. I don't want to interfere.
Goodbye, Kenny.
Put the keys down.
Oh, God.
Don't blaspheme.
What do you want from me? With the police arrest?
A fellow brother.
Why'd he confess?
Because he is a son of God, like I am. And he loves me. He would do anything for a fellow brother. I noticed you're a fellow brother as well.
Yes, I am.
I noticed that from the very beginning. That's why I haven't killed you yet.
What?
I said, I haven't killed you because you're a man of God and a good man. I can tell. How much do you believe?
It's my life.
Are you saying that because I have your life in my hands?
I'm saying it because it's the truth. How can you kill people and say you're the son of God?
I'm going to let you live because you have faith. And I want you to remember that when things got tough, it was faith that saved your life.
I don't care what you say you are or what you believe. You deserve to die.
Is that so?
Yes. And if I get my hands on you, kill you, you motherfucker.
That's not very Christian. But you must believe strongly to say that with your life in my hands.
Around?
No. He got taken in for some hooker racketeering this morning. I ain't paying his bail.
I need a gun.
What? Just because I'm a whore, you think I have all sorts of illegal hookups?
Yeah, I do.
Fuck you. What's it worth to you?
Maybe 20 bucks.
Go see Aiden. Down the road. Should be out on his porch around this time.
I thought you quit.
What? I didn't recognize you with like pizza boxes.
I knew you'd be back here.
Yeah, why is that?
Because you're a drugged up junkie whore.
Fuck you! I should beat some sense into you again, you fucking asshole. Run away from a girl. Hey, look at me, fucking pussy, faggot. Look at me when I talk. Look at me, hey, fucking faggot.
Tell you what, I'll call them for you. If they don't see the tracks on your arms, they'll run you in for prostitution for sure. Good luck finding a job with that new face. Aiden?
Yeah?
I need a gun.
Hey,
I got 100 bucks.
Will it
get me?
Down.
What'll it get me?
I said keep it fucking down. Come here, come here. 100 bucks ain't gonna get you much. Maybe Saturday night special or a 38. Planning on killing a man?
That'll do the trick. It's the 9mm. Side shifted, busted on the side. Can't piss straight, but it'll do the job.
I'll take it.
I recognize you. You're the fucking pizza delivery boy who ripped me off $10!
I remember you too now. Laughed at me when I got the shit beat out of me. Wouldn't lift a finger to help me. Told me to stop being a pussy, remember?
I was wrong.
You're a worthless piece of shit.
Get the fuck out of my house.
Parents know you're running guns with your college tuition?
Hey, what my family does is their fucking business. Now get off my fucking property.
I'm looking for the guy that lives across the street over here.
Matthew?
That's right. You know where he is?
No, he left. He hasn't returned. There was a murder outside of his house the other day, and I haven't seen him.
I heard about that. Is he with the police?
Wait, who are you? What do you want again?
I'm a friend. I owe him money.
For what?
A bet.
A bet? Matthew doesn't gamble. He volunteers at the church. He's a good guy. I don't know what this is about.
What's your name?
Sherry. I don't...
He's not a good man, Sherry. Don't say anything. Just come with me.
Mom, I'm gonna be right back.
Just come with me.
You don't have to pull my arm like that. What do you want from me?
Get in. Get in. I want to know who this Matthew is. I want to know why he suddenly decided to go on a killing spree. I want to know why he's left me alive, now he's free and clear. And I want what I've always wanted, answers and a peace of mind. What's this?
This is a church where Matthew volunteers.
Great.
He'll be here on noon. Can I go home?
We stay here.
I don't understand. Why are we here? What do you want from me? What do you want to do with Matthew? You're not going to hurt him, are you?
Do you know what Matthew has done?
No, I don't know what he's done. What could he have done that's so bad that you're chasing him with a gun? Okay, his friend from church killed that boy in front of Matthew's house, okay? He was a nutcase. Matthew is not that way. I've known him for years. I trust him. He would never do anything to harm anyone.
Do you believe in God?
Oh my gosh. Yes, I believe in God.
How do you do it?
What do you mean?
How do you do it when there's proof he doesn't exist? Like that boy that was killed outside your house.
I think that's a test of faith.
A test of faith?
Yeah.
So God is willing to kill an innocent man just to test us? Sounds like he's just an asshole.
Maybe God didn't get him killed.
If he didn't get him killed, why didn't he at least try to stop it?
Maybe he did try to stop it, but maybe this boy wanted to get himself killed.
You're wrong.
Maybe I am.
What are you doing?
I'm tired. I'm gonna take a nap.
He's early.
Wait. You haven't told me what this is about. What are you doing?
Stay here.
Where are you going?
Sherry, you just don't get it, do you? What are you planning on doing? You planning on killing me? It can't happen. I have faith. God won't let me die.
Bullshit. I could kill you right now.
That first shot, you had me. You missed. That was God.
No, it wasn't. The barrel on the gun is off.
Here, I'll prove it.
Get back!
Even if the gun doesn't shoot straight, you can't miss. Pull the trigger. Kill me. It's you against God now.
I'll fucking kill you.
You see? You get it now?
How can you believe in God and do what you do?
That's a good question. But you're gonna have to find the answer on your own.
I could still kill you.
Yes, you could. But that wouldn't accomplish much, would it? Justice would be served, but you'd still be searching for answers.
Why'd you spare me? It wasn't just to frame me.
You're right. It wasn't. But I think, if you want to find the answers, you're gonna have to stop asking the wrong questions.
God damn it!
Ugh.
Where the hell have you been? The cops have been calling me all day long. You don't answer the phone. Tara doesn't answer her phone.
Tara's dead.
Who's dead?
Tara, now where the fuck are the keys?
Sit down, we need to talk, son.
There's no time. He knows what my car looks like.
That's the only time you talk to me, is that it?
That's right, now where the
when
fuck
you
are
need
the
to
keys?
Borrow my car, put them back! Put them down! What's that for? Hey! Get back here! What are you doing?
Since you'll never see me again after today, I guess I can tell you this. I'm gonna kill a man, and there's nothing you can do to stop me.
You were always good for nothing, Kenny. You and your damn Jesus, your damn church. Good for nothing. And your sinner, your mother. And how did she end up?
I don't know, and I don't care.
You need help, son. You need to listen to me. You owe me that.
I owe you nothing.
Well, please. Listen to me!
I don't have time for this shit, Dad.
Well, God be with you then.
You found the answer, Kenny.